For the first time in 2 years, some families will also start paying for school meals again.
COVID-related federal funding has now stopped, and that means a cost of up to several dollars a day. Jennifer Hoff looks into the options still available when finances are already tight for so many. Jennifer?
They are, Julie. Children can still, though, remember, apply for free and reduced priced meals, just like pre-pandemic. But now the state is enrolled in a new pilot program that makes that free food available to thousands of new students. Here's how.
For 20 years, Hunger Solutions has been committed to feeding Minnesotans, including students. Its executive director says tonight is no different at an event to raise money for the nonprofit.
All we're asking now is that there's enough money to be able to support kids to meet their basic needs as they go back to school.
Colleen Moriarty supports making school meals free permanently, a move California, Massachusetts, and Vermont leaders already signed into law, a proposal that didn't pass Minnesota's last legislative session that would have cost $183 million a year.
I think that we all know and agree on one thing, and that is that children need to be fed to be able to learn. And they don't need to be encumbered with policies that punish them or their parents because they can't afford lunch.
School lunches can cost about $3 a piece, and with COVID-related federal funding for meals now stopping, some parents are on the hook for that again.
So preparing for school this year means that for a family of four, it could be $150 a month, and that's real money.
Children can still qualify for free and reduced meals, including SNAP, and now if they're enrolled in Medicaid and meet certain income guidelines, according to a new announcement from the Department of Education that helped the federal government select Minnesota and seven other states to participate in a year-long pilot program to identify even more students who qualify for free meals. That, as of now, is upwards of 90,000 kids.
Why was Minnesota selected to participate in this pilot program?
We knew that we had to take a look at other ways on how we get families into these programs and get them access to these programs without having to go through the paperwork burden of filling out those forms. Well, this isn't going to capture every single one of those kids. It's obviously capturing a pretty significant amount of them.
And the new kids who now qualify are just automatically enrolled in this new program based on previous eligibility from other programs, some of which, though, remember, you do still have to sign up for. But Julie, the need is already very evident in some districts. We know in Anoka Hennepin, for example, there were about 5,500 kids that qualified for the free and reduced meals. Now under this new program, that's jumping up to about 9,200 kids expected this year.
All right. Thank you, Jennifer.